हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द वीएलसी डिज़ाइन कोर्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर नेक्स्ट कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट एंड वेरी एप्लीकेटिव कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट लाइक मल्टीप्लेक्सर्स एंड डी मल्टीप्लेक्सर्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू राइट VHDL कोड फॉर द मल्टीप्लेक्सर and its complete simulation, synthesis, creating a UCF file and generating a bit file for that this development board. So on this development board we can see the implementation of multiplexer. So we have switches, so through these switches we can give the inputs, we can observe the output on these LEDs, and we can give the select line through these switches or either from these same switches. So let's move ahead. So which are the design steps? As usual, so we should know the logical concept of the multiplexer. To write any VHDL code, we should know its logical implementation. So let us understand little bit. Already we have covered multiplexer examples in our earlier videos, combination circuit design and their examples. So what is a multiplexer? Multiplexer, also shortly written as a MUX, is a combination logic circuit designed to switch one of the several input lines through a single common output. So multiplex, so it has a simple, we can say, many inputs, single output. So to direct this many input signal to a single output, definitely we required some select lines. We need a select lines. So below are the two applications are shown. So here we can see here multiple inputs, input data are routed to a single data out through this data selection switch. So this data selection switch is nothing but the multiplexer. Similarly, in to manage the amplitude of the amplifier, that can be controlled through these kind of multiplexers. Okay, so let us take an example of 4:1 MUX. So in 4:1 MUX, the 4 itself is says it has a 4 input, 1 output. Now to select these 4 combinations, we need a 2 select lines. So the equation for the select line is select lines is equal to, or the select lines we can identify using the formula 2 to the power n. So here number of input lines are 4, so 4 is equal to 2 to the power n, so n value becomes 2. So it depends on the number of inputs we are choosing. For example, if we are choosing number of inputs are 8, then the select line becomes 3. If it is a 16, select line becomes 4. So number of input combinations, there is always a relation between input to select line combination. So we know very well about the truth table. When select line is 0, 0, this I0 will be connected to Y. When 0, 1, this I1 will be connected to Y. When 1, 0, it is connected to Y. And if I3, it is connected to Y, if it is 1, 1. So let us start writing a VHDL code for the multiplexer. So this pin assignment will come later on. Let us first complete the VHDL code, simulate it, synthesize it, and then we'll come back to this pin assignment. So let's start. File, new project. So I'm giving project name as a multiplexer. Then these parameters are always same because we are using our same development board. So Xilinx, Spartan 3A family, XE3S50A device name, then its package TQ144, other parameters are same. So let's create a project. Then let's add the source file, new VHDL module, then file name MUX. We are creating 4:1, enter. Okay, so here how many inputs we have? We have total 4 inputs, 2 select line and 1 output. So let us select 4 bit input, or we can give I0. Okay, so I will give I0, I1, I2, I3. So total 4 inputs. Okay, all are of type in single bit, then we are giving a select line. So I am giving a directly a signal select line with a bus width directly 1 down to 0. So 2 bit bus I am declaring, and here one output y. So here we have to declare it as a y, then next, finish. Okay, so as usual it will declare predefined libraries, then entity declaration, and here we have to write our logic. Okay, so now to write a multiplexer program, we can use, again there are two concurrent statements, when else and with select. We are focusing right now on these statements only to get much more understanding of these concurrent statements, and we should be used to with these statements. So till now, whatever the designs we have developed or written in VHDL code is in the when else. So let us start writing a code with the with select concurrent statement. So let's start, begin with SEL select. So here our selection is from the SEL signal. So this is the expression for with SEL select. Sorry, some mistake. Select then. So the syntax says that with that expression select, then target y. So y has a signal assignment. So y is equal to i0 as per the truth table. Y is equal to i0 when select line is equal to 0. So let's write it. The syntax says is i0 when. So here we are not going to write like in when else. We are writing in when else, we are writing directly SEL is equal to 0, 0. So here directly we have to write its choice. So select is equal to when it is 0, 0, and here we have to give a comma. Here we have to give a comma. If my choice is i0, i1, we are assigning i1 value when our choice is 0, 1. i2 when our choice is 1, 0, and i3 when our choice is 1, 1. Or here we can say, because with select clause we have to end with the when others. Okay, so we can terminate here. Otherwise, one more additional signal we need to assign it for this when, in this with select. So let's compile it. Okay, then let's synthesize it. Okay, then view the RTL schematic. So it creates a mux. It creates directly a mux having three input select line and the output port. So like this we can see the synthesis and the simulation also, but we are not giving more time for the simulation. Let us generate a UCF file and let's create a bit file for further implementation. Okay, so I am direct moving ahead with the generating a bit file. So right click, new source, implementation constant file. So this is for the mux.ucf user constant file, then next, finish. So it creates a UCF file. Now we have to write a UCF file. So again, go back to our presentation. Okay, so now to implement mux functionality on this development board, we are going to use this switches as a input as well as for the select line, and LED as a output. Now in our design we have four inputs. Okay, so this upper four switches, switch 1, 2, 3, 4, can be used as i0, i1, i2 and i3 as input, and last two switch I am using for the select purpose. So SEL0 and SEL1, and we have only one output, that is one LED we can connect here. So that is output LED 0, and that pin is connected, that pin location we are mentioning is a 141. When this J15 is connected to P4 header of the P4 header of the FPGA, and this J14 we are connecting to the P1 header of this FPGA. So let's start writing a UCF for this 4S2 burn marks. So everyone knows the syntax. Well, let's start. So syntax is net, then signal name. Signal name is I0. So first input, then location is equal to P31. Am I correct? Location is equal to P31 for I0, then I2 P32. So let's copy it, paste it. 32 for I0, I1. Then I think it's a 28, I0, I1, I2, I3. It's a 30. Okay. P30. Then now we have to assign two select lines. So for two select lines, for yes of 0, we are going to assign, because MSB I am giving to P44, so yes of 1. So not yes of 1, select of 1 we are assigning to P24. And select of 0th bit we are going to assign to P25, and only one output is remaining, that is Y. It is assigned to pin number 141. Okay, save it. So we'll just cross check it, our signals. So input I0, I1, I2, I3, select line 2 bit, Y is the output. I0, I1, I2, I3, select line 1 down to 0, and Y is output. So let's generate a programming file. So it's generating the bit file. So our design is ready for the implement on the development platform. So for the implementation of the design on our development board, we'll see this implementation in our next lecture. Thank you.